Scripture for today's message is Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to 3. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. For by it the man of old gained approval. By faith we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things which are visible. Manuel Choir and Nisi Orchestra will glorify God with their praise.
Pastor Soojin Lee will deliver a message under the title of Faith. Be blessed and receive grace through the message and receive healing. Let me introduce Flow Offering by Men Cell District Cell Leaders. We give thanks to Father God for leading us to this church, able to hear the gospel of life. Especially through a special prayer meeting, cell leaders revived through the fervent prayers. Thank you. We hope that we can experience the power of God, of love, in this special divine healing meeting. With the resolution to become faithful cell leaders. Thank you. We have very special guests for this Friday online service. We have Paul Lee from Germany. Now, when he stands up, please welcome him with your big hand. Emmanuel Choir and Nisi Orchestra, thank you for the praise. And Senior Deaconess Jang Mi-hee, thank you for your special performance. Her resume is great, right? We got so many talented people. I believe you are ready to give your talents and commit your talents to Father God, right? Senior Deaconess Jang Mi-hee, you know, I thought, you know, we'll be just happy to listen to her, you know, performance. Congregation loves you. And GCN, thank you for Manmin Magazine. And those who were healed by faith, you listen to their testimonies. Doctor said, you know, they couldn't be treated even with the medicine. Even the doctors said so, but by the power of God, by faith, they were healed. So they didn't spend any money. They just, you know, came to church with their faith. The one who had the problem with her, you know, kneecaps, doctor said that it would take long for her to get healed. But by the power of God, you know, she was healed in a very reduced period of time. And then, for better, you know, she came to have faith, which could not be purchased with money. You cannot buy faith with your money, because, you know, you can receive, you know, answers by your faith, right? You know, once you have faith, then Father God could give you billions of dollars once you have faith. But you cannot buy faith with money. You can start with a little faith, but you can increase that faith. And Father God will listen to your prayer. They have witnessed the works of Father God's power. And they decided to depend on the power of God, and as a result, you know, they were healed. Now, Your Christian life would be different. Just as I said, you know, once she was healed of her, you know, kneecap, she now comes to Daniel prayer meeting. She has never imagined that before, but now she comes to Daniel prayer meeting and she's happy. So all of them, they were healed by faith, and their Christian life has been changed. And those diseases, you know, even though they could be healed by the medical doctors, you know, when they were healed in this church, you know, they came to have a better faith. Now, what about those diseases which, you know, doctors could not heal? You just depend on God. Father God will say, you know, if you depend on the world, then, you know, the Father God will say, you know, you got no faith. You cannot be healed. You depend on the world, you depend on your wisdom, and you just try to do whatever you saw fit. But when the world cannot do anything with your diseases, you just come to God. That's not faith. You have witnessed countless works of God's power. Then, once you experience that, then it's got to be the foundation of the faith that you can show even a little. But that's what they did, and they were healed. I believe that tonight will be another moment of the blessing. The title of this message is Faith. In the second half of this service, there is a divine healing meeting. So what kind of desire of heart did you bring tonight? Probably you want to receive healing, or blessing, or answer, or the fullness of the Holy Spirit. So each one of you has, you know, your own desire or prayer titles. And the Bible explains how to receive answers in a very easy way. Psalm 37 verse 4 says, delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. And also, if you can delight yourself in the Lord, and Father God will give you answer. And if you please Father God, then He will give you the desire of your heart. Father God can heal you. Father God can bless you. Then if you please Father God, then naturally you can receive healings and blessings. Now, how to please Father God? It is also written in the Bible. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith, it is impossible to please Him. If you come before God by faith, you can receive answers to any kind of desire of your heart. So for this reason, I would like you to look into faith today. Faith is the key to blessing that we can receive. It's like a master key that, you know, if you ask God by faith, you can receive answers to any problems. Master key, okay? That's faith. You may have all different desires and prayer titles, but that faith can be the master key. Mark 16, verse 17 and 18 says, these signs will accompany those who have believed. In my name, they will cast out demons, they will speak with new tongues, they will pick up serpents, and if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. You know, picking up serpent means not just the picking a snake, okay? This is breaking the authority of the devil, okay? Now, those with true faith, when they pray in the name of the Lord, they can do something impossible. Even demons be cast out. Those with true faith can be given such spiritual authority and power. You know, furthermore, they can receive the power of God. Only Father God can give. Now, those blessings that our Lord just mentioned only happened in the days of our Jesus. Well, we witness them right now through the prayer of man, just as our Lord said in Mark 16:17 of chapter 16. It's actually happening in this church. You heard testimonies. Those who received the senior pastor's prayer for the sick, those who were healed in the divine healing meeting, as they were healed, they are so full of happiness and joy. This is the third divine healing meeting of this year. Last January and February, in Seoul, Korea, I prayed, right? Now healing works took place in and some other places in the globe. Those who suffer from demons, they were cast out. They were set free from demons. Especially in India, there was a man who was set free from demons. Now, from February, there were other testimonies of those who were set free from demons. Nowadays, there are so many people who suffer from demons and evil spirits. I believe your family is at ease and happiness. You can find a relative who suffer like this. They try to, be treated with drugs or medicine. But after that, they suffer from other complex diseases. And evil spirits work even worse. But by the power of God, but through prayer of faith, such evil spirits and demons being cast out. So I have another testimony from India. She, by the name of Namira, she suffered for 10 years by evil spirits. She ate with her hand, just like in her grandchildren. Now, her family came to know about Ma Min, and when she suffered a lot, her son forced her to receive prayer for the sick by senior pastor 7 times. After that, she became calm. So she started to attend Sunday services. And when she attended February Divine Healing Meeting, she received the fire of the Holy Spirit. And then her heart became ease. And then she just became like a normal man. Now she is free from the nightmares. Now, after she was healed, now they came to have in the local sanctuary, and now there is a family service, and whenever there is a family service, 15 to 20 people gather every Sunday. Now she confesses that she is happy to become a member of Ma Min and flock to our shepherd. I have another one. By the name of Jari, at the age of 24. He suffered from evil spirit since 2017. He felt like his blood got sucked by that evil spirit. And he became very weak. Through YouTube, he came to know about GCN. And he heard about the Divine Healing Meeting in February. So before that, he read the message of the cross, he repented, and he prepared himself for the Divine Healing Meeting. After he received the prayer, all the symptoms and pains were gone. Now he's living a happy and blessed, healthy life. Now that family were in great debt. But after all the family came to Ma Min, they got job and then they paid off all the debt. Johnny, at the age of 32, he came to have depression in 2018. He had sense of committing suicide. He couldn't have conversation with other people, but he sent prayer request through Delhi Ma Min Church after he heard about Divine Healing Meeting in February. And through YouTube, he received the prayer. And after receiving prayer, He got no, you know, thought of, you know, committing suicide or a negative thought. He became healthy and he can do her job. He can do his job well. He gives all glory and thanks to Father God. Father God can solve all our problems. They took all kinds of medicine. They received the medical doctor's help, but nothing could help them. You know, even the fleshly thought, and controlled by evil spirit, that they couldn't control. You know, even the man had the thought of, you know, committing suicide, and they became very weak. All these kind of, you know, problems they had were solved, and they were healed by the power of God when they received the prayer for the sick through, you know, transcending space and time. Now, as you believe in Father God, who is good like this, in this church, which is full of God's power, how good and how happy you are. There are so many people who couldn't, you know, solve their problems, but they requested. And then once they received prayer, they got, you know, answers to their prayers. There are so many people who received answers, who received the healing works. Now they run toward the heaven with the hope for a new Jerusalem. So Father God will bless us all the more to evangelize the whole world. And, of course, the enemy, devil, and Satan try to interfere with these churches in the ministry, but we can overcome them, right? So this is the blessing for those who got faith. I hope that you can receive this kind of healing works and blessings through this divine healing meeting. Now, do you believe that the Bible is the Word of God? In the Bible, there are many scenes, you know, various kinds of difficult problems were solved by faith. Matthew 9:27 said, as Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, crying out, "Have mercy on us, Son of David." And Mark 5:29 said, immediately the flow of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. But by her faith, you know, she was healed. Now in Luke 17:14, when he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they were going, they were cleansed. Not only in the New Testament, but in the Old Testament, amazing healing works of God took place. You know, when they were great, you know, when there was no rain for 3 years and 6 weeks, the widow and Zarephath received the blessings by the prayer of Elijah. And what about Elisha? I mean, the general Naaman. When he obeyed the word of Elisha, the man of God, you know, he was healed of his, you know, leper. Now, the widow and general, even if they had the power, even if they had the intention to obey the word of God, if there had been no man of God there, they couldn't receive the blessing. So she was blessed to become the widow who could obey the word of the man of God. There was a man of God, and she served him. So she received the blessing. So even though you got little faith, to bless you, Father God tries to work through a man of God. You have to know the principle of this spiritual blessing. General Naaman obeyed the word of Elisha, and he was healed of his leprosy. This kind of blessing, this kind of healing works, only can be done by the power of God. General Naaman obeyed Elisha. After went on obeying the word of Elisha, he was healed. He dipped himself into the river of Jordan River 7 times. That's what Elisha said. There was a man of God, and there was a prayer of Elisha. But if General Naaman had not obeyed the word of God, he would not have received the healing works. So you gotta, at least you have to come with faith. Even if you have faith, if there is no prayer of man of God, chances are very little. However, General Naaman showed his faith, and there was a prayer of man of God, Elisha. And when he obeyed, such healing works took place. So, by faith, any kind of disease can be healed. Now, there are so many people who say they believe, but they don't receive blessings. They say they believe in Almighty God, and they go to church. They confess that they are children of God. But still, they have problems. Why don't they receive answers 100%, even if they say they pray by faith? There is nothing impossible in our God. God is faithful, and He keeps His promise. So what's the problem? The problem lies with your faith. You've got to check if your faith is the true faith that God can recognize. People may say they believe. However, a Father God cannot recognize it as a true faith. If you read Mark chapter 9, you can find the father whose son was a demon-possessed. He asks Jesus to, heal his son. Mark 9:22 says, "It has often thrown him both into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, take pity on us and help us." This is what that father said. Then, but in verse 24, he said, "Immediately the boy's father cried out and said, 'I do believe, help my unbelief.'" Well, don't you think it's logical? He said, "I do believe. Help my unbelief." Well, actually, it's a true confession. He heard that Jesus healed so many diseases and cast out demons. And he had a wish for his son to be healed. He heard the rumors. He heard the news. So he thought, my son would be healed by Jesus' prayer. Since I heard that he could, cast out demons. He could make, even the deaf hear and the mute speak. That's not true faith. My Lord can do it. That's faith. However, this man didn't experience the power. So he heard it, but he got just knowledge, not faith. Well, I think he can do it. What if he cannot? So it's a knowledge, not faith. He knew it in his brain, but he didn't have perfect faith. So he said, "I believe. Help my unbelief." So you have to check whether your faith is true faith. You say, "I believe." However, you have witnessed the great power of God manifested through our senior pastor. You witnessed them a lot. So you think you believe it because you saw them a lot. However, once you got sick, you can see whether, you have true faith or not. When your friend got sick, you ask your friend to receive your senior pastor's prayer. But what about when you are sick? When you ask your friend to ask receive senior pastor's prayer, you seem to have faith. However, when you are sick, you may think, "Well, if I go to hospital, I can be easily healed. What if I just depend on the prayer of senior pastor and if I don't get healed?" If it is your case, that you cannot show your faith, that's not true faith. So there is true faith and false faith. As written in James chapter 2, there is living faith and dead faith, and faith that can receive answer and faith that cannot receive answer. So two kinds of faith, spiritual faith and fleshly faith. Faith that can receive answer from Father God is spiritual faith. However, fleshly faith cannot be recognized by Father God. So you got to check what kind of faith you got through this message. First of all, let's look into fleshly faith. First, fleshly faith is the faith of knowledge. You believe what you can see. You believe what is in accordance with your knowledge. Let's say, this desk is made of crystal. The top board is acrylic, right, plastic. But the pillar, you know, of this, you know, the legs of this desk is the crystal. Then you believe it, because that this kind of info is in accordance with your knowledge. So you believe it, but that's fleshly faith. However, there are so many information that is not true, which may change over time. You received that information and you took it as knowledge. And you believed it, but that's not faith, because it can change. You saw the works of God, but when you try to fit what you saw into what you think, then it cannot work. Only the word of God is true truth, which can never change. Some people say, I believe in God, but they don't completely trust in the Bible. They only believe what they think right. There are so many things in the Bible that cannot be explained by worldly knowledge. What about maras in the bitter water turned into sweet water in the days of Moses? And the manna and the quail came down from heaven. Jesus healed so many people. Even he revived even the dead one. With fleshly faith, people cannot believe all the records of the Bible. They cannot believe when such signs and, you know, power of God can be manifested. They don't believe. But you have witnessed them and you believe. You believe that bitter water turned into sweet water. Manna and quail came down from heaven. And there were three magi followed in the moving star to worship the baby Jesus. Now, can you say, well, was it possible? You don't say so because you witnessed the actual work. So now you naturally believe. However, there are people out there, even Christians, they don't believe in the Bible completely. Why? Because they didn't experience what we experienced so far. They come to church. However, when they read extraordinary signs and miracles in the Bible, they don't believe. Let's say, well, when the Bible said, you know, Jesus walked on the water, you know, they think like this, you know, maybe Jesus walked on a very shallow water. However, we witnessed a lot, so we believe everything in the Bible. However, there are people, even if they see things. And that's fleshly faith. You gotta see the difference like this. We have witnessed so many power of God, signs and miracles. So we came to have great faith. Now, to make the faith actually yours, what should you do? You have to, you know, you gotta rethink again. True faith is believing in the word of God completely, absolutely, regardless of your thought and knowledge. Now, do you believe in every record in the Bible? If you truly believe them, then you may show the evidence in your life that you believe in Father God truly. If you truly believe that Father God is Almighty, you must be able to show the evidence in your life. When you face difficulties, sadness, you believe in Almighty God. So you can pray by faith with joy and thanks. Then you should receive answers to your prayers, and you've got to solve problems. Now, when you face some kind of problem, your face got frowned and then you seem to be in very trouble, right? But think about Father God who has led this church, who established this church, who gave His great power to our shepherd. Now, where did power come from? It is from our Father God. Father God gave the power to our shepherd. Now, when you witness the power, then you gotta see, you gotta think that the Father God is alive. Why did senior pastor pray to receive Father God's power? To help people possess true faith. They say they believe. However, they complain when they, encounter some problems. In order to help such people to possess true faith, he wanted to manifest the power of God. The power of God is the evidence that Father God is alive. Now, even the whole world confirms that this church is full of God's works. So far, for the last 37 years, Father God has guaranteed this church with His power. Now, you must believe that Father God is leading this church. Now, but when you, faced some kind of troubles, and then you doubted whether there was a work of Father God in the church, then you got to check your faith again. We said we got faith. Elders and pastors, senior deaconesses, you've been in this church for 10, 20, 30 years. Workers, all of you, you witnessed the power of God, and you said you believe in living God. Father God started this church, I believe it. You said so. You have to ask yourself whether that faith was true faith, whether it was spiritual faith, whether you can see invisible Father God too. If you truly believe, then as you witness the evidence of Father God still happening in this church, then you don't need to be afraid. Why do you lose your fullness? You can't. Since your faith was little, you were shaken. So you got to repent, actually. Why? Because Father God has showed you so many evidences. If you read the Bible, those in the people who escaped from Egypt, when you read the Bible, don't you think they were too much? I mean, they witnessed the power of God through Moses. Moses did a great job. However, when something was not in accordance with their thought, they complained against Moses. They even said that they want to go back to Egypt. They saw, witnessed the power of God. But what about you? In this church, the Father God guarantees. You witnessed the power of God. You got to ask yourself whether your faith was true faith. If your faith is true faith, then Father God will answer your prayer all the time. When you pray with such faith, then you can see how Father God is leading this church and which direction. You will see. However, if you didn't see, then please, you got to repent of that, especially in the second half of this service, and possess true faith. I told you that the pleasing Father God is faith, which you can do it even if you don't reach the fifth level of faith. At the first level of faith, if you please Father God, then Father God is very pleased with that faith. Now, at the fourth level of faith, people do not show the proper deeds. They have worldly thoughts. That cannot please Father God. People at the fifth level of faith, when they face troubles, they worry. They become sad, and they complain. Well, we witnessed that. Sometimes the people lose their faith like that, but it should not happen. Anyway, even if they were called and they were in the fifth level of faith, you know, they lost their faith. So many workers are called, you know, standing on the rock of faith, and they reach the third and fourth and fifth level of faith. There are so many people in the church. You are given your measure of faith. Some. Now, you can check your faith, your level of faith, by the word of God. Your faith was not shaken. Then, your faith is standing on the rock of faith. Now, then, such a faith Father God is pleased with. Then, once you have that kind of faith, then your deeds of faith should, you know, the constant all the time. When you face trouble, if you can please Father God, then your problem can be solved. But there are people who don't receive answers to their problems or healing works to their diseases. You know, there are people who depend on the world once they have problems, even though they say they believe in God. That's not true faith. That's faith of knowledge. You know, when they confessed that they seem to have enough faith. However, when they face trouble, they depended on the world. They depended on the doctors. That's faith as knowledge. They say they believed in God. But when they don't receive answer as they prayed, they go back to the world. They use their methods. Then that's the evidence that they didn't believe in God. That's fleshly faith. I want to tell you my testimony. I believe many of you heard this. At the age of 6, I got concussion. I think I went on an errand for my mom, and I was hit by high school students. You know, they were playing football, I guess. I was crossing that road, and then there was a student who fell on me, you know, while backsliding, and then I fell down to the ground, and my head struck down bottom of the ground, and then the student called his parents, and his parents took me to hospital, and the doctor said, you know, I was in a concussion, and then I should be brought to a medical center to be properly treated. And then senior pastor and Mrs. Bong Lin Lee were called, and then they came to the hospital. But once they heard what the doctor said, you know, they didn't take me to the medical center. We just came back home. Back then, I was unconscious. I had some bubbles coming up from my mouth, and there was no pupil were seen on my eyes. But they took me home. Why? Because senior pastor was healed. The moment he kneeled down before Father God, he took all kinds of medicines to be healed. He was not healed. However, once he met God, he was healed all at once. If it is a disease, a normal doctor can heal, it can be healed by Father God. Even if it is a disease that cannot be healed by a medical technology, it can be also healed by Father God. So, you know, they took me home. Even the doctor said, you know, I would be, chances are that I might be healed, but, you know, I might be, you know, full. So anyway, they took me home, and then I received his prayer 3 times a day. Well, I was unconscious, so I didn't know what was happening. A day passed. Second day passed. The third day, it was Wednesday, and the senior pastor was a student. And he prayed on my head, and he was about to leave. And then I came to senses right away. And then, Dad, I gotta go to Wednesday service, right?
제가 정신이 잘못돼서
I came to sense.
지금 뇌진탕으로
I was unconscious for 3 days.
내가 잘못돼서 정신이 이상해서 월요일 날 다쳤는데 지금 수요일
I got hit. I fell down to the ground on Monday. Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I came to senses, and then I just said to senior pastor, I want to go to Wednesday service, right? And then I seemed to just wake up from a deep sleep. So and then senior pastor came back from school, and then but I was not there because I went to Wednesday service. I acted as if nothing happened to me. So now I got no after effect. I was 6 years old. Probably, I must be an adult if I had depended on the world. But senior pastor and Mrs. Bonin depended only on God, and I was healed by God. I'm healthy, as you can see now. But then that faith became my faith. So as my parents showed their faith, I became healthy. I was unconscious. I couldn't remember, but I came to senses. They told me what happened, and I believed it. It became my faith. I was unconscious, but by faith of my parents, Father God healed me. Through His prayer, I became normal like this. I believed it, and I was able to apply that faith to whatever happened to me. So experiencing Father God's work is a great blessing for you. Now, senior pastor didn't see the reality. He would have taken me to hospital, right? But he didn't just depend on the world. He only depended on Father God. He showed his faith. It was not faith as knowledge. It was spiritual faith. Father God, after he met God, he lived his life only by that faith. And that kind of faith cannot be shaken if it is a spiritual faith, and it works. Now, you said, I believe, and you received the prayer, but there was no work of God, which means the faith was not true spiritual faith. You came to church, as others said, they would receive blessing, they would receive prayer. Faith is not just a lip service. If you confess your faith, then you gotta live by faith. You gotta show the deeds of faith in your life. Those non-Christians enjoy themselves in the world. They drink, they smoke, they live opposite to the Word of God. But those Christians should live by the Word of God. And when they encounter some problem, then they receive prayer and their problem can be solved. However, Christians, Christians depend on the world every day, don't live by the Word of God. Once they encounter problem, they come to God and receive prayer, it does not work. Now, secondly, fleshly faith is a changing faith. Let's say you got a desire and you pray to God. However, Father God does not give you answer. So what do you think? Does God truly lie? Does God truly live? Some people doubt the existence of Father God. They said they believed in God and they prayed to God. But when they didn't receive answer, they doubt whether Father God truly is alive. Moreover, some people think when others say they received answer, they say that's coincidence. So such changing faith or doubting faith is not true faith. Our Lord said in Mark 11:24, therefore I said to you, all things for which you pray and ask, believe that you have received them, and they will be granted you. You have received them. It's before you receive it. Father God has not given it to you, but say that you have received it. Some non-Christians say, that's, you're forcing me. However, if you pray by faith, and then you should say, I have received it. Then that's true faith. Now James 6 verses 6 and 7 says, But he must ask in faith without any doubting. For the one who doubts is like the surf of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. For that man ought not to expect that he will receive anything from the Lord. So changing faith is not the faith that can receive answer from Father God. Once you believe in Father God, that faith should not change in any situation. You believe in Father God. In any given situation, the faith should not change. In this church, the works of Father God, the power of our shepherd. When other people say, that's not power of God, then it's not. No way. You are not healed by the senior pastor's prayer. You are healed by Father God's power. Of course we were healed by the power of God through our senior pastor's prayer. That's true, isn't it? Last Sunday, Pastor Yoo Sung-gil, testified. 25 years ago, he testified. His wife, Pastor Choi Byung-nan, she had the lump in her womb. About the size of 5 centimeters, 25 years ago. And then but she was pregnant, and the doctor said, it's urgent for her to receive, an operation. But she got dream, and in her dream, senior pastor appeared. And the senior pastor, in her dream, senior pastor put his hand on her, app. And then, after the dream, she felt that she was healed, and then she got diagnosed in the hospital, and then the lump was gone. Now, you can think, right? Father God works, but why senior pastor appears in a dream? Father God works for sure, but why senior pastor appears in dreams? Usually in our dream, senior pastor appears and prays for us or touches us. Then the next day we are healed. Surely Father God works, but he works through our senior pastor. Now, not only 25 years ago, even today he works like that. Even if someone says no, then it's nothing? No way. Well, the doctor diagnosed wrong. I didn't have, lung in the beginning. Well, 25 years ago, there was a lump, and through senior pastor in a dream, and then prayed, and then she got healed. That's true. That's a true story. It cannot change. Now, what if you changed? Your faith got changed. Well, I think it's coincidence. That's not done by senior pastor's prayer. Father God cannot be pleased. He'd rather be sorry. Father God healed through senior pastor. And you said, it's not. Then your faith got changed. You cannot please Father God. Then if you pray to Father God cannot answer you. Now, if you have that before, then you got to repent of it. Of course, my members do so. Don't do so. You have received blessing through our senior pastor. Your faith cannot change, right? Now, fleshly faith is changing faith. If you doubt your healing works, if you deny the healings that you experienced before, it means your faith got changed, then you got to repent of it. If you changed, then you lost your faith, or your strong faith became very weak. You lost your faith, right? Then how can you receive answer with that lost faith? So you got to repent of it. Father God, please forgive me for changing my faith. You got to repent of it. That's fleshly faith. Now, thirdly, fleshly faith is the faith without a deed. James 2:17 says, Even so, faith, if it has no works, is dead, being by itself. So fleshly faith is dead faith. People think knowing the word of God is believing. They are confused like that. They just know the word of God. But God is alive. He created everything in the universe. You know it, but that's not faith. You don't believe in heart. You say you believe just because you know it. However, if you truly believe in the word of God, then you gotta obey the word of God. If you don't believe it in your heart, but if you have it as knowledge, then such deeds will not come out. Say, Senior Pastor made this example. Let's say you are very thirsty. Now there is a glass of water like this. Do you believe that your thirst will be quenched if you drink this water? You drink it because you believe that your thirst would be gone after drinking this. You might have experienced it. Somebody has told you, right? And you did that, you experienced it, and your thirst was gone. Do you believe it now? You believe that if you drink it, your thirst will be gone. Well, what if you don't believe it? Oh, I'm so thirsty. Should I drink that or not? Why? You never experienced it. You don't have faith that your thirst would be quenched through drinking it. You will not drink it. Because you don't believe that, you know, you doubt whether your thirst would be quenched by drinking it. It's the same. If you believe in Father God, if you love God, you will live by the word of God. That's true spiritual faith. That's the faith that you can show to Father God to receive answer. If you truly believe in the word of God, you will live by the word of God. But those with fleshly faith do not show their deeds even though they say they believe. Say, your father is the world's best cancer surgeon. Now, you got cancer. Who do you call for? If you truly acknowledge that your father is the best surgeon in the world, then you will call for your father and you got an operation. You got surgery from your father. You don't need to look for any other doctor. Right? Now, you say you believe in God, but once you got sick, you go to hospital. When you pray, you say, you are Almighty God. You say, you are God the healer. However, once you got sick, you go to hospital. Why? Because you don't completely believe that Father God is alive and He is Almighty. If you don't have such a faith, you depend on the world, right? If you have faith, then you just come to God. You don't need to spend that much money. You save your time and money because you just depend on God. Well, I'm confident to say this. If you can believe in Father God, you can be healed by Father God. Father God can do anything even the world cannot do. Now, this church, with this church, does not force people not to go to church, not to go to hospital. Some people come to me and say, well, should I go to hospital because I'm so sick, I'm seriously sick. Well, I heard that doctor is a very good doctor, and I can be healed. That's what I heard. Well, that's your faith. Your faith is like that. However, Father God can heal even deadly diseases. When you show even a little faith before a man of God, then Father God can work through the man of God. Now, Father God says, you gotta give tithe. He said in the Bible, if you don't give tithe, you are stealing what belongs to God. If you give tithe, Father God promised to give you abundant blessing. Now, if you truly believe in this word, then you would give tithe. He met God when he was a sickbed for 7 years. Then he met God. Once he was healed, he started to read the Bible. Now he found how to receive, you know, blessings. When he was sick, you know, he got tremendous amount of debt. No, they couldn't pay off the debt, even if both, you know, husband and wife, you know, worked. However, the secret to receive blessing was found in the Bible. So he believed it. He held on to it. That was giving full tithe. So whenever he earned money, then he had to pay the debt, he had to make living, he had to, you know, he couldn't even pay the interest of his debt. However, once he read the Bible, first thing he did was giving tithe. Why? Because he believed in God. Father God gives blessing. Gold is mine, silver is mine, everything is mine. If you live by my word, then I will give you blessing. He believed it. He cannot even pay the interest.
So
he couldn't maintain in a normal life with whatever he learned. However, he believed in the word of God. So whenever he got money, he gave tithe first. Of course, momentarily he had trouble. However, once he showed his faith like that, once, twice, three times, four times, since he believed in Father God, with joy, Father God sooner or later blessed him. Once he experienced it, he could do more and better by faith with joy. So in a very short period of time, he was able to pay all his debt. Then later, he became number one who gives the most offerings. So the poorer, the better you gotta hold on to the word of God. Now, if you don't believe in the word of God, you cannot show this kind of deed. Fleshly faith, there is no deed. Now, you count your money. Well, if I give my tithe, then I cannot buy textbooks for my child. Since you don't believe in the word of God, you don't give tithe. This church is not forcing you to give tithe. This church doesn't do that. You just do it by your own faith. However, we explain it because it is a key to receive blessing. This church does not emphasizing on in the giving offerings. But this church teaches you how to receive blessing by giving tithe and offerings. If you count, you cannot give tithe, you cannot give offerings. However, once you have faith, then you can give to Father God. Well, if I once give it to Father God, then I can receive blessing for sure. You believe it, and you have great expectation. You can show that kind of deed, and Father God bless you for sure. You got knowledge, but that's not faith, so you cannot show the deed. Father God does not acknowledge this kind of fleshly faith as true faith. And such people cannot receive answer even if they say they believe. So you got to repent. If your faith got weakened, look at yourself now. When you're happy, when you were joyful, you gave offerings. You showed your deeds. Now, what about you? For the last couple of months, did you try to follow the goodness? Did you try to give? Did you try to help others? You're still doing it? Or you did a lot before, but you don't do it now? You think you were good before, but you are not now? Of course, you may have some roots of sinful attributes in your heart. But what about those in the root of sinful attributes grew up for the last 3 months? Well, you are passing through the moment of refinement. That's actually a blessing. Because you can realize that those unseen sinful attributes were found in this period. That's a blessing. You used to teach others to get rid of them. But now you found them. You realize that such a sinful attributes were found in you. And you lost your deeds of goodness. You're going to repent of it. You used to have faith, but you know, answer is coming slowly nowadays. Then you got to check your faith. You are standing on the rock. You have spiritual faith. Then you got to show, you know, proper deeds of faith accordingly. You were deemed to have faith, but you showed some kind of, you know, a deeds of unfaith, unbelief. Then your faith got, you know, backslided. Then you got to repent of it. And you got to regain it, right? And then you got to increase your faith even greater. Now, what kind of faith can be redeemed, can be deemed as a good faith? It's exactly opposite to those in a fleshly faith. First, spiritual faith is the faith that you believe every word of God, even though it is not in accordance with your thought or knowledge. That's the faith of Abraham. Father God made a promise with him, saying that Isaac would be the seed of blessing. Now he told him to give Isaac as a burnt offering. He promised that, you know, Isaac would be the seed of blessing. But Father God told him to give Isaac as a burnt offering. If Abraham did not believe in Father God, then he might have used his fleshly thought. What he's saying is not in accordance with what he used to say before. He would not have obeyed. However, Abraham didn't use any fleshly thought, but he obeyed. Hebrews 11:17 says, by faith, Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was offering up his only begotten son. Hebrews 11:19 said, he considered that God is able to raise people even from the dead, from which he also received them back as a type. He believed that Father God would revive even the dead Isaac. Such a great faith that it was. That's why he was called a friend of God. He pleased Father God with his perfect faith. That's true faith. That's a spiritual faith. The current refinement, if you look at it by faith, then you can see Father God's plan and providence. So you can be thankful, you can pray more, you can be faithful more. You don't see the reality, but you focus on the work of God. Then you will find things that can please Father God. That's spiritual faith, not knowledge of faith. Not the faith that can see the reality. But if you have spiritual faith, when you look at the things happening inside this church, then you can see it in position of God. Then you can say, how can I please Father God all the more? Now I can see what's happening in this church. We are in the providence of Father God. I want to get the perfect score once he scored my, you know, my faith. You got to feel it. You got to know it. You got to realize it. You may say, well, I should have done better. What if Father God say, why didn't believe in your shepherd completely? I gave you word of promise to you. If you had believed it, you would not have lost your faith. But why did you lose your fullness? Father God might say like this. So I think like this. When senior pastor was here, we seem to have, you know, good faith. We seem to be very good. We seem to work hard for sanctification. Now, senior pastor is now around. Now we can see our true self. That faith was not the faith through our senior pastor. Now you look at your true faith, the faith of your own. Even though I walk in the shadow of the valley of shadow, the shadow of, you know, death valley, you know, I can be at peace. Can I really give thanks? Can I be at peace? Even though I am, you know, in this period of, you know, refinement. This is the time that you can check your faith. For months, You witnessed your faith. It's not too late. If you are short, repent of it. And then, please, Father God, in the future. Now, repent of what you're short of in the second half. Father God, as I'm passing through this moment of blessing, I wasn't able to please Father God a lot. Please forgive me. Let me regain my faith back. Let me please you. Please repent like this in the second half. Secondly, spiritual faith is unchanging faith. Once they believe without changing. It is not the faith they can give up in the middle. That's not spiritual faith. I told you my testimony, right? I was unconscious for 3 days. What if senior pastor had not had, you know, perfect faith? You know, Mrs. Bong-in Lee had the good faith too. You know, well, my daughter is so sick. She is dying. She is unconscious. You know, don't you think we gotta take her to hospital now? If she had little faith like that, you know, she would have done like that, right? However, senior pastor and Mrs. Bong-in Lee, both of them had great faith. So 3 days passed by. They didn't doubt at all. They got no doubt. What if my daughter didn't come back to senses? They didn't doubt like this. Should I take her to hospital now? They didn't think like this. They didn't change. Once they believed in Father God, that faith didn't change at all. After I got accident, Father God didn't heal me right away to see whether their faith was perfect faith, whether their faith would change or not. However, since they believed in Father God 100%, even though the answer was coming slowly, they didn't doubt at all. They just believed that Father God would work. They believed in Father God till the end. He prayed and he went to school. I came back to sense, and I said, you know, I want to go to Wednesday service. Now, you got to show this kind of faith. Now, this kind of faith cannot be easily gained from the beginning. Well, if I, I showed my deed, but the answer is coming slowly, you doubt, then you got to repent right away. Father God is almighty. I remember, Pastor Sujin's testimony. I should not doubt. I gotta believe 100%. Father God will surely work. As you can see, as I told you, you just remember all those testimonies. If you think you have there is a slight chance of, you know, having doubt, then you gotta repent. That's the way you can increase your faith. If you show your faith 100% like this till the end, and then you got to ask Father God to have spiritual faith again and again, and you got to show the deed to please Father God. You can pray more, you can even fast when you pray, or you can show your, you know, works of faith, which you didn't do before, or think more or better. Then Father God will be pleased with you, and He can give you the spiritual faith. Check your faith. You said you believe, but when the answer is coming slowly, didn't you doubt? Didn't you change your faith? You gotta look back. Now, thirdly, spiritual faith is followed by deeds. That you obey the word of God. James 2:22 says, "You see the faith was working with his works, and as a result of the works, faith was perfected." And 1 John 5:3 says, "For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome." If you believe in God and if you love the Lord, then deeds must accompany. If you love someone, then you try to do what your beloved one wants to have, right? And you will obey. If you truly believe in Father God, if you truly love Father God, then it's not difficult to keep His commandments. However, some people seem to obey the Word of God, but sometimes they don't keep the Word of God. Even though they say they believe, it's little faith. And they cannot expect perfect answer and blessing from Father God. Say, you don't hate someone. You don't do evil. However, when someone slanders, when someone calls you a bad name, then you lose your joy. Well, in this kind of case, the Father God will not say you did some evil work. But what about if you are a church worker, you're a pastor, or you are an elder? Now, when someone do something wrong to you, then you may complain and you grow weary, and then if you don't change, if your faith becomes spiritual faith through those moments, then you cannot receive spiritual faith. You didn't hate someone at first. However, you feel uneasy when someone does something wrong to you, or when you got sick, even though you prayed, you don't receive answer, you don't receive healing. You say, I didn't do anything wrong, but why don't I receive healing works? Then you gotta find something what you did wrong. You gotta repent everything. Like, from the depths of your heart, if you pray and sing praises, then Father God will give you realization. What have you done wrong? You may regard it very trivial, but, once you come to Daniel prayer meeting, you try to look back on yourself during the prayer, and during prayer, the Holy Spirit tells you what was wrong. Well, when someone did something wrong to you, you hated him. That's hatred, isn't it? If you don't love someone, that's hatred. You realize that you had hatred. You didn't obey the word of God. That's why I didn't receive answer. You realize it, you repent of it completely, and then you show the deeds. You show the deeds of love. Even someone who did something wrong, you try to, you try to be in good terms with him, and you just do show good deeds to him, then Father God will give you spiritual faith. You prayed, you don't receive answer. There was something that I didn't obey the word of God. That's why I didn't receive spiritual faith that can receive answer, since I didn't live by the word of God. You repent of it, and you begin to live by the word of God. Then Father God will give you spiritual faith, which can receive answer to your prayer. As you live by the word of God like this, then you can receive answer. Now, how much do you obey the word of God in the Bible? 10%? 20%? 50%? 70%? To the extent you believe, spiritual faith can be given to you. Do, don't, keep, cast off, how much do you obey? To the extent you can resemble the heart of the Lord and recover the lost image of Father God. And to that extent, you can be given spiritual faith. Romans 12:3 says, for through the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think more highly of himself than he ought to think, but to think so as to have sound judgment, as God has allotted to each a measure of faith. To the extent you live by the word of God, Father God gives you spiritual faith. When you pray with that spiritual faith, you can receive answer. Now, as you listen to this message, you realize that you came to have fleshly faith. That's why you didn't receive answer. Now you realize it. Now, but don't lose heart. Even though you are short, you repent of it. Now you ask for spiritual faith. That's what Father God wants for you. You just make up your mind. Then Father God, good God, will heal you. Once you make up your mind, and you gotta show your deed after you make up your mind, then you can live a healthy life. I've been in the church for 10 or 20 years. I didn't live by the word of God though. Even though I saw so many works of God, When I faced a little trouble in my life, I complained. That's not spiritual faith. Now I realize. So Father God, you could not give me answer. Now you realize it through this message. Then repent and turn back. Then Father God will forgive you. Father God, please forgive me. I didn't live by your word. Even though I said I believe in you, even though I witnessed so many works of God in this church, I used to have fleshly faith. So please forgive me when you repent of it. Now I told you how to have spiritual faith. When you live by the word of God, then when you show the deeds of faith, then you can receive spiritual faith. I'll give tithe. I will volunteer. I will work. I will serve others. When you show the deeds of faith like that, Father God will surely work for you, heal you, and bless you. Let me conclude this message. Let me tell you about what I told you so far. Your faith will grow if you act according to the deeds and the principles. If you don't change, if you keep the word of God, if you don't doubt, you can have spiritual faith. Your faith can grow up. You now realize why you didn't receive answer. You learn the spiritual faith. Now, make your faith show that your characteristics of spiritual faith, then you can receive answer. Someone said that they believe and they trust, but they left the church. Some people didn't leave the church, but they lost their fullness. That's changing of faith, isn't it? They realized some root of evil that they thought that they can't stop before. An old habit comes out. It means they lost their faith. However, we heard the gospel of holiness, and we aim for New Jerusalem. It's not too late. If you backslided, repent of it. Now regain the beautiful heart which was pursuing the sanctification and goodness. You can regain your faith. We should check ourselves quickly before Father God's prepared blessings come. I think this is what our Father God wants us to do at this moment of blessing. If you backslided, realign, and have this moment as a chance of regaining. And I hope that you will become a man of New Jerusalem through this moment of blessing. Father God will show you and give you abundant blessings and answers as you grow up in these difficulties. I pray in the name of the Lord that God's abundant blessing will overflow in your family and business and workplace. Mark 9:23 says, if you can, all things are possible to him who believes. I pray in the name of the Lord that his word may be with you in your life and in this church all the time. Let's think over the message and pray together.
좋으신 아버지 하나님, 오늘은 은사 집회에 우리가 치료받고 응답받고 문제길 받고 축복받기 위해 믿음에 대해 살펴보았습니다. 아무리 아버지 하나님의 그 놀라운 권능을 많이 보아도 목자의 크신 권능을 많이 보아서 우리의 믿음이 큰 것처럼 느껴져도 실상 내게 어려움이 오고 현실에 시험 환란이 올 때 믿음을 내보이지 못한 육적인 믿음은 내게 없었는가, 아버지 또 왜 육적인 믿음이었는가 살펴보았습니다. 자신을 정확하게 볼 수 있게 하여 주옵소서. 또 어떤 이는 영적인 믿음으로 달려온다 하였으나 연단의 때에 그 믿음을 육적인 믿음으로 바꿔가지는 않았는지 퇴보하지는 않았는지 이런 모습들도 회개하게 하시고 이제 지식적인 믿음이 아니라 현실을 보지 않는 영적인 믿음을 갖게 하시고 변개하지 않는 믿음, 말씀대로 지켜 행하는 행함 있는 믿음을 모두 가져 큰 영적인 믿음을 소유하며 응답과 축복의 주인공들 되게 하여 주옵소서. 이후에도 회개의 역사로 축복하여 주시고 치료와 응답으로 함께하여 주옵소서. 감사드리며 우리 주 예수 그리스도의 이름으로 기도하옵나이다. 아멘.
영상을 통하여 당회장님의 환자를.
Let's receive senior pastor's prayer for the sick on screen. Lay your hand on the sick part of your body. If you are not sick, lay your hand on your chest and receive this prayer for the desires of your heart. Hallelujah, Almighty Father God of love. Please lay your hands on all believers who are receiving this prayer now. Show your works that transcend space and time on those who are receiving this prayer through satellites and on internet and GCN TV in branch churches and local centers around the world. Give them the faith to believe and drive away all negative thoughts and doubts and drive away all tests and trials. From head to toe, all entrails, joints, nerves, tissues, and cells, whatever the sick part may be, burn them with the fire of the Holy Spirit and with the original light. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil, and Satan, all diseases, germs, and viruses, infirmities, go away. May the light come. Scorch all the terminal and incurable diseases with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Drive away all endemic diseases such as malaria. All contagious diseases such as cold, flu, and fever, go away. Father, protect them from all kinds of germs and viruses. And heal them of all stomach cancer, lung cancer, liver, breast, uterine, and intestinal cancers. AIDS, leukemia, cerebral apoplexy, high and low blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid diseases, heart diseases, lung diseases, and women's diseases and all inflammations, go away and be cleansed. Heal them of polio, stroke, arthritis and herniated discs, back pain, headache, neuralgia, and all other pains, go away. Epilepsy, autism, depression, neurosis, and other mental diseases, go away. All kinds of paralysis, be loosened. Get up, walk, and leave. Let the eyes see well. Let the ears hear well. Let the blind come to see, deaf come to hear, and the mute come to speak. Heal them of after effects of all kinds of accidents and fix their broken bones. Restore them from burns. Let the heat and burning sensation go away. Let there be no burning skull left. Be cleansed from all kinds of drug addictions, poisoning, and substance abuse. Let the dead nerves, tissues, and cells be regenerated and bring the dead back to life. Give them the blessing of conception. May you receive the blessing of conception. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy devil and Satan, the ruler of the air, and evil forces of darkness, go away, and their servants also go away. Go away, you evil, unclean, false, and deceitful spirits, separating spirits and all forces of darkness. Loosen the bonds of wickedness. Darkness, you go away. May the light come. Father God, give them strength to cry out in prayer and to cast off sin and to become sanctified. As their soul prosper, let all things go well with them. Let their family be evangelized. Protect them from all kinds of accidents and disasters throughout this week, and bless them to lead a prosperous life without any problems. With the firewall of the Holy Spirit, with heavenly hosts and angels, and with your blessing eyes, protect all your children, their family, workplace, and business. Give students wisdom and understanding, and give them fervor and passion to study hard. Please keep their hearts and minds from the worldly things and let them love Father God all the more fervently. Whether your children eat or drink, whatever they may do, let them do it all for the glory of Father God. Let them say, I met God, I experienced God, I received answers and blessings. Let them testify with their lips like this. Father God, thank you. Be glorified alone. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
涙の中おられ主、愛の主、それは命与える救いの主。